Friends, in the last lecture, we have learned on how to create a user and how to get the user, how to get a particular user, delete a user and update user. Along with this API's implementation, we have learned how to throw a exception in case of validation failure. And we have added @valid annotation. Under user model, we have added the validation annotation @size. And custom message, and whenever exception comes, it goes to exception controller, custom exception controller. From custom exception controller, this function will be invoked. Okay, whenever exception comes, it throws the method argument not valid exception invoked, and we have send the customized response. In case of user not found, this function will be invoked because it throws, we are throwing user not found exception. And we are returning a response. Similarly, if any generic exception comes, response will be sent from here. Until now, we are sending the JSON response only, and we wanted to send XML response and receive XML response. So let's try with XML. See what will happen. Get users. In headers, we have to specify accept application/XML. Hit the API. Whenever we hit, sorry guys, server is not up. Let me start the server. After starting the server, we'll invoke the API and see the response. Let's see the response. Server is up and invoke the API. And we are not getting the response now. We are getting 406 not acceptable because we have specified application/XML as the response. And what is happening? Spring is returning only JSON response, and Spring or microservices are not supporting XML. It supports only JSON. To support JSON, we need to add one dependency jar and search for in Google. Okay, in Google. Format XML. Search for this dependency and copy the dependency from here. Copy the dependency, and this dependency we need to add in form.xml file. The form.xml we need to add the dependency. Format it. Until now we are getting JSON response from here, from Jackson. We have Jackson libraries. From Jackson, from here we are getting the JSON response. Now we have added the XML support also. Automatically Spring return the XML response. If user wants XML response, Spring converts the Java objects to XML. Previously it was converting. When user want JSON, it converts Java object to JSON. If user wanted to have XML response, automatically Spring converts Java object to XML. Dependency and source codes are downloading. Now application is building and it will be launched. Started now. Let's hit the API. Friends, we are getting the response now. We are getting XML response. Previously we have got 406 error. Now we are getting 200 response, which means automatically Spring converting Java object to XML, and we have specified accept application/XML. Let me insert a record, and we have only 3 records. Let me insert 4th record. Okay, Kiran, Bangalore, age. HTTP method will be post. To create a resource, HTTP method is post. 201 created, under headers, will get the location. Here, user is present. So, get is working. get all is working, post is working, let me try for specific user. Body, the body will be present. This for this it should be a get method, not post method. Get method, we got the XML response for specific user also. Just quick recap, we have added the dependency JSON data format XML, and from consumer we are expecting application/XML. That's all. It automatically converts Java object to XML. That's all. Thank you, friends.